Welcome back to Anything Outdoors with Steve. We're here back at Pyramid Lake, and we're going to do a little heat hike here. I think we're looking at 100 degrees today, and so I've packed plenty of water and water filters for this hike. But this is a shorter hike, so we should be all right.
The last time we were here, there was about 3 feet of snow on the Forest Service Road, and we were hiking in the rain. So I suspect this is going to be a different hike today. We'll probably be able to get up over the top of Pyramid Lake and go visit Ball Lakes as well. And the view from up there of Pyramid Lake is worth the effort, I think.
I think so too.
All right.
All right.
Here we go. We're not going to get there. Stand here. We have choring to do.
All right. Here we go. Out of that world into this one.
Okay.
Get on up there, boy. Important notice.
Please vacate from the premises. Immediately upon your seat.
See, so as you're going down, when you take your tumble,
yes,
it can just see that, it can say, man, that you were so graceful, and you just did that with class.
You are much more diplomatic than I when I see him tumble. Yeah, when we take tumbles and we get it on video, we make sure to exploit that to the fullest. Did you guys overnight last night?
Yeah, we've been up there for 4 days. So
oh, awesome. Where'd you stay? A pyramid?
Yeah.
Did you hike up to Ball Lake?
Yeah, twice.
And then do Trout Lake?
No.
Didn't do Trout Lake? Yeah.
No, that was too much.
That's it. Yeah.
Too much, and Ball Lakes are really pretty, and the hike up there was really nice. So, I mean, why do you want to go that extra distance and then...
For a secondary view, exactly.
Right.
Yeah, the lake from Ball Lakes, I mean, the view from Ball Lakes... trail down on Pyramid, that's as good as you're gonna get up
and
there.
Look for the hoary marmot up there.
Okay.
You know up on that view area in the big rocks.
Day
before yesterday we saw a marmot up there sunning itself on the rocks. So
rumor has it that one of us always carries some unsalted raw pecans. It's unsubstantiated. It could be true. Could be true or could not be true. You guys have a good rest of your hike for the next 37 seconds.
Thank you.
Yeah.
workers.
Give these guys shovels and picks.
Oh man, I knew we walked into a trap.
Yeah,
it's an ambush. Oh, I thought I was getting out of work today.
Yeah.
Oh well, that's the story of my life. For every time I turn around the corner.
Oh yeah. Come through here, you have to do work.
I was gonna camp out up there.
Oh no. Just taking a little peek. And...
It's pretty.
Yeah, it's pretty.
I know.
Yeah, you're making a nice highway in here.
Trying to improve the highway.
Yeah.
An improvement zone.
Yeah. Quite a bit different.
Last time I came up here, it was really cold, as I recall. Really cold.
This is quite a bit different. I think we were off trail quite a bit.
Yeah, there. I was thinking the same thing.
And so I think we might have been down there as we were trying to climb up. I fell over backwards and you were trying to lift me, and we decided to just go for it straight up.
Straight up.
Yeah. Everything's a trail.
Mm-hmm.
What's going on over here? There's a puppy dog. They said, "Lot of puppy dog." Hey guys, what's going on? What's going on? Did you go for a swim? Upper.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are on top row. Now, children of the corn, we are on top of the world now. So instead of taking the sensible choice and hiking back down to our truck and going home, we decided that we would climb up the mountain behind Lower Ball Lake, whatever this mountain is called. We'll find out later. Yeah. And it is glorious up here. You can see the Selkirks in all directions. We're going to try hiking down a different ridge just because. So if you don't see this video, then we're probably up here still getting eaten by squirrels or something. And if you do, it means we made it back safely. No, bears are too smart to come up here.
your step. Like you got to sit down to get on that one. Get down. Yeah, I don't think we should be playing around too much, focusing on pittering and or pattering. Yes.
Yeah, it's flat all the way. Yeah, see, just like here. Mostly flat. I floated.
What?
Floated.
How did you get down?
Yeah, that's a nice ridge trail there. Left. Yes, it is. Want to swap off?
No, I'm just trying to figure out where our best
route down departure off. Down. Yeah.
Just turn it down.
Yeah, it might be a bit of a scramble going down that face there.
Might be right here.
Yeah.
Not here.
No. No, not here. That's a hang glider trip here. Got enough tailwind though. I know.
Look over here. Well, let's look and see if we can't see our...
Yeah. No, definitely not there, but
yeah,
if you follow this, it's fairly flat, zigzagging down.
Does it zigzag down?
It does zigzag. So I'm going to stay up.
Dirt on top of the granite.
So I'm going to stay on this rock here and then shimmy on down that little ledge.
Yeah.
Just get a good handhold on everything before committing. Plenty of handholds. Man, this feels good on the knees. Oh, I think your butt slide is
it's
pretty grippy. Oh yeah, this is no problem. And handholds in case you slip. Man.
Did I run across it?
Just yeah, sideways. You don't need to run, just walk across. It's pretty grippy.
Okay. All right.
So now we've got our choice. Do we hang to the right and follow the rocks down, or hang to the left and follow the rocks down? 50-50.
That's a pretty nice,
I like it,
trail right there for now.
All right, let's hang the right.
I don't know what it is beyond that.
Yeah, we'll find out.
Story.
I don't think there's anything here that we can't get off of.
No, this is easier than what we just came up.
I know. I got a granite rock in my shoe. Digging. So I'm gonna sit and take it out. Slippery. Oh.
Those hiking poles.
Yeah, jeez, every time. Even right there when you're stopped.
Yeah, they're good for balance. Okay, now.
All right.
Question is how?
I think, yeah, that way.
And then down to that.
Yeah, careful on this grass, though. So.
And then we have minimal, get across the minimal scramble.
Mm-hmm.
And then we're,
mm-hmm.
And then we start the lake.
Yeah, just be careful on that grass, it's slippery. These boulders, no problem. Grass, eh.
Yeah, these loose boulders.
Yeah.
They're great.
They are great. View at least. That looks doable.
What's that?
That looks doable.
Down here, right?
Yeah, just straight down this way.
Straight down.
Yeah. You got a little bit of a granite shelf, but angled a bit, not bad. The downside is we have to get all the way back over there to our trailhead.
Yeah, we have to skirt the lake.
Yeah, and that's a lot of boulder skirting.
It's a lot of boulder skirting.
Yeah. Not impossible.
Not what?
Not impossible.
Not impossible, but a lot of boulder skirting.
Yeah. Yeah. We might be using flashlights on this one.
Do you have flashlights?
Of course. Wouldn't be ultralight without flashlights.
especially heavy ones.
Yeah, they are heavy ones, actually.
Heavy ones are good.
Yeah.
Heavy flashlights.
All right.
Here we go down.
Mm-hmm. See if we can get you on film going down, too.
Mulberry bush.
I kind of like this quartz vein here to walk on. It's nice and rough. Yeah, this isn't so bad. How those knees feel?
Woo-hoo. Yeah, they're taking a little hammering. It's okay. It's all right. We'll hold out. Here, stay right down.
Yeah.
Right down there, and then down the little.
I agree.
Sidewalk, right?
Hmm.
Yeah, down the little sidewalk.
What are the chances you could go straight through the woods and find the trail?
You know, stranger things happen.
Yeah.
Stranger things happen.
I'd want to see that on the Garmin first.
Okay,
yeah.
That's a treacherous
yeah.
path
above
the lake, isn't it?
Sure is.
What's our
Maybe we go up through the woods above the...
Yeah, if we follow this grass across, across here, and then maybe you take the woods above the lake.
Mm-hmm. And then don't even bother going down to... And take above the boulders. They'll find us path of least resistance.
Of course, this one has bare grass.
Sorry.